We have seen before that it's not very difficult to guess some of the formulas to compute the sum of some sequences. For example, summation from k equal 1 to n of 2k minus 1 equal to 1 plus 3 plus up to 2n minus 1. Computing summation from k equal 1 to 1 of 2k minus 1 equal 1. Summation from k equal 1 to 2 of 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 plus 3 equal 4. Summation from k equal 1 to 3 of 2k minus 1 equal 1 plus 3 plus 5 equal 9. Summation from k equal 1 to 4 of 2k minus 1 equal 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 equal 16. And we can suspect from this that summation from k equal 1 to n of 2k minus 1 equal n squared. We have shown with these computations that the formula is valid already for k equal 1, 2, 3, 4, but we are very far from proving that the formula is valid for any natural number. Even if we found that it's valid for a million natural numbers, something that can be done using computers, it could happen that the formula may fail for the next natural number and therefore will not be valid for all n natural. For example, the Swiss mathematician Euler found a simple quadratic polynomial that seems to always produce prime numbers. A prime number is a natural number that is only divisible by itself and 1. The polynomial is n squared plus n plus 41. This formula does give prime numbers for the first 39 natural numbers, but once you arrive to n equal 40, the resulting number is a square number, 1,681, which is equal to 41 squared, and therefore a composite number. It is also immediate to see that the result of replacing n equal 41 in the formula will also be a composite number. It will be nice to find a method that allows us to prove that some mathematical proposition is valid for all natural numbers. The Italian mathematician Francesco Maurolico, in his Hermeticorum Libri Duo in 1575, found a method to prove the statement summation from k equal 1 to n of 2k minus 1 equal n squared for all natural numbers. His method of demonstration is very peculiar and was not widely known until the French mathematician Blaise Pascal published another work entitled Treatise on the Arithmetic Triangle. And there he uses again the method now widely known as mathematical induction, so named in the book Arithmetica Infinitorum, Infinitesimal Arithmetic, by the British mathematician John Wallis. To illustrate the idea of the method of mathematical induction, let us place a set of dominoes in a line, such that when one falls, the next one up the line will also fall. The number of dominoes we use in the example is finite, but you should try imagining an infinite domino. Then, what should we do if we want all the dominoes to fall? Push the first one. The magic of the principle of mathematical induction is that we actually only need to prove that the first element satisfies the property and that for any other arbitrary element, k, assume that if it satisfies the property, then prove that the next element, k plus 1, will also satisfy it. Since element k we have picked is an arbitrary number, then we can reach any number. The principle of mathematical induction is executed in just two steps. If P sub k is some proposition depending on k we need to prove, where k is a natural number, we first prove that P sub 1 is true. Assuming that P sub k is true for some arbitrary k, derive from here that P sub k plus 1 is also true. As a consequence, we have proved P sub k is true for an infinite number. When we go from assuming P sub k true for some k and deduce that P sub k plus 1 is true. So, let us try applying the principle of mathematical induction to demonstrate that summation from k equal 1 to n of 2k minus 1 equal k squared. As we have seen, the formula is valid for k equal 1, since summation from k equal 1 to 1 of 2k minus 1 equal 1, which is equal to 1 squared. Now, we will assume the formula is valid for some arbitrary natural number n, and try to get from there that it is true for n plus 1. So, summation from k equal 1 to n of 2k minus 1 equal n squared, we'll assume is valid. Adding 2 times n plus 1 minus 1 on both sides, we get summation from k equal 1 to n plus 1 of 2k minus 1 is equal to n squared plus 2 times n plus 1 minus 1 equal n squared plus 2n plus 1 equal n plus 1 squared. And this is exactly what our proposition will look for n plus 1. Therefore, we have proved that the proposition is true for any natural number n. This method of proof is very powerful and is used to prove many propositions that depend on n natural.